Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Let's talk about grave threat. You say that, Mr. Alvarez, you say that it's, well, it's institutional as to how we really assign grave threat, but yet we haven't defined it. And so it really isn't only institutional, but it's also environmental. In other words, it depends on the current economic environment at the time. Wouldn't you say that's correct?
Yes, I think those are both factors.
So it's more or less a game time decision as to determine whether a grave threat exists. I mean, how else do you anticipate it?
Mm-hmm.
And if that's the case, then let me ask you, are there any particular financial institutions today, without naming names, is there presently any company that poses a grave threat to the U.S. financial system within the meaning of Section 121 today?
So, you know, in the other part that fits into
But are there, I mean, you've had 2.5 years.
I'm sorry?
You've had 2.5 years to determine whether there's a grave threat by any institution or any company. So are there any today, again, without naming names, that you would consider pose a grave threat to the financial stability of the United States?
So remember, the other thing we have to take into account in deciding grave threat is whether the mitigants that the, you know, higher capital restrictions on activities, other regulatory and statutory factors have reduced the risk of the institution.
But absent
we're
a definition.
We're in the process of still doing those rules and getting those requirements.
So there aren't any. It's safe to say there aren't any then. There are no
We've
companies
no
out there.
We've made no findings of that so far.
Okay. Because why? Because there's no quantitative metrics of existing as to how to apply grave threat?
Because we have still the Dodd-Frank Act provisions, the preliminary requirements to get completed and imposed and then react to.
So let me ask you this, point blank. Do you have any quantitative metrics that you use now to determine whether a company may be a grave threat?
We do not have a quantitative measure. That's.
Do you anticipate having any?
That's a possibility.
Any within the next year?
So we're in the process of doing what the statute requires, which is to put in place the mitigants that then are applied to all large institutions.
Understand the logic and reason here. How can you quantify the expense associated with mitigating a threat you can't even quantify? In other words, this is a situation where you've got no standard. There's no standard, as we know, that exists for grave threat. You determine based on, I guess, discretion at the moment that what may consider to be a grave threat today may not be a grave threat tomorrow. So if there are no quantitative metrics and there are no standards, what all has the Fed done in the last 2.5 years in discussing what would constitute a grave threat?
So as I indicated, we're following the process Congress has set out for us. And that includes establishing these mitigating factors, which are higher capital, restrictions on growth, restrictions
on
activities.
So it could be size, it could be capitalization, it could be a number of things. And who would the grave threat be to? Consumers?
To the financial stability of the United States economy.
And how would you determine that? I mean, have you had discussions as to how you would determine the grave threat to the United States?
So certainly we think about many things at the Federal Reserve, including what we'll do with grave threat, but we've not made any proposals or made any findings at this stage.
So does it take, under 121, does it require that a company must first be in bankruptcy as a precondition to be considered a grave threat?
No, it doesn't.
And under 165, then, you can really be a grave threat if you just don't have an appropriate living will. Is that correct? I mean, if it doesn't meet your standard.
You mean requires sell assets. There's
right.
No connection between the grave threat in 121 and 165.
Right, right. Grave threats on 121. But.
Right, on 121, the institution has to have a plan that's not credible and refuse, and the agencies have to jointly determine that. We then have to impose other requirements on the firm. The firm has to not only not live up to those requirements, but not put in another credible capital plan, and then there's a 2-year waiting period.
Real quickly,
it's all laid out
in the statute.
I've
only got a couple of seconds. I guess what I'm getting at, and my point is that there are no standards available right now to determine grave threat for either a bank SIFI or a non-bank SIFI. Is that correct?
That's right.
And it seems to me then that we are not discussing whether a bank or any other institution is too big to fail. What seems to we be discussing is that for 2.5 years, having a lack of procedure and regulatory rule implemented, we have a situation of too late to save because you are not going to be able to save these institutions if you have no standards in place by which they know how to correct what they don't even know is incorrect. And I believe my time's up, so I'll yield back.